रक्तेवल बिगिन तो जरा धमा दवा जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यशोदनंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तीरावन चारी यमुना तीरावन चारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे ग्रंथराज भगवद गीता की जय श्री प्रभुपाद की जय वी आर इन चैप्टर 4 वी हैव टू बिगिन फ्रॉम वर्स 20 लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन Okay, so we are in the chapter 4, Transcendental Knowledge. And we are in the section where Krishna is teaching us about karma, vikarma, and akarma, right? So, we are still in section C. Hopefully, we can finish that section. Or maybe we still have a few slokas left. We don't know. Let us see. So, this section is about understanding karma on the platform of jnana. So, how to get akarma, where you don't get any reaction of your activities. So let us see. Okay. So we'll revise this verse 19. In verse 19, Lord Krishna says, one is understood to be in full knowledge, whose every endeavor is devoid of desire for sense gratification. He is said by sages to be a worker for whom the reaction of work has been burned up by the fire of perfect knowledge. So, this is inaction in action. So, one who understands action in action, inaction in action is perfect knowledge. So how he acts? He does not desire for any sense gratification, but he desires only to serve Krishna. And because he is serving Krishna, there is no reaction for any action that he performs. And that is called akarma. So the action that you do, there is no karmic reaction. So let's move to the verse for today. Scrolling down. Okay. So such person is abandoning all attachments to the results of his activities. He doesn't have attachment to the results of his activities. He is ever satisfied and independent. He performs no fruitive action, although engaged in all kinds of undertaking. So akarma does not mean that one has to quit working, but one has to work for satisfaction of Krishna. When Krishna is satisfied, we are satisfied. When the root of a tree is watered, all the branches and leaves are watered. Similarly, when we satisfy Krishna by our activities, so when we offer all our activities to Krishna, then Krishna is satisfied and we get satisfied. So he is engaged in all undertakings, but he is satisfied because he is offering everything to Krishna, but he is not offering something to have his own result for himself. So, okay, so one is not attached to sense gratification. So karma phala asangam, he is not attached to the karma phala. He is detached from the fruits. That means he is not throwing out in the street all the fruits. Whatever the result he gets, he offers to Krishna. Ever satisfied, and he is independent. Does not depend on any other shelter. That means he depends on Krishna's mercy. So in these two verses, 21 and 22, we learn about the qualities of one who works in such consciousness, in that transcendental consciousness. That means in Krishna consciousness. So verse 21 will tell about somebody who is practicing, and 22 is about somebody who perfected, further advanced. So verse 21, such a man of understanding acts with mind and intelligence perfectly controlled. So one who is in sadhaka stage, that means practicing stage, he tries to control his mind and intelligence, and he gets control over them. And because he is controlled, he does not hanker for sense enjoyment. He is not thinking this belongs to me. He understands that everything belongs to Krishna. Krishna is a proprietor of everything. So I will take only for the bare necessity of my survival. That's all it is. Srila Prabhupada says, it is a best use of bad bargain. Says, you know, we are in an awkward situation in this material body. We are going through different kind of suffering because of being in material world. We cannot deny that. We are suffering because of our own mind intelligence, because of other living entities, and because of the natural calamities. So it's a bad, so, you know, best use of bad bargain. So the best use is that keep your body and soul together and engage in Krishna service. When we work like that, then we do not get any sinful reaction, because at that stage, one is not attached to the fruit, but he is just attached to Krishna. So here is that na apnoti kilvisham. Kilvisham is the sinful reaction. So there is no kilvisham. Srila Prabhupada writes in purport, we will read it together. So he says, just as a hand moves with the body, just as a machine part moves with the machine, and just as an animal moves with its owner, a devotee acts always according to the desire of the Supreme. So actually, yes, we are part and parcel of Krishna. Krishna is the whole machine, and we are his parts. So we are his instruments. So we have to move as per Krishna's desire. Then that's the perfection. Srila Prabhupada gives the example, like if there is a branch of a tree, or if there is a limb of body, it's cut off, separated from the whole body, separated from the body, there is no value of that cut off part. But when it is joined, it is connected with the whole body, then it is living, it is acting, then it has a value. It is a part of the body. It is the part of the whole body. So like my hand is my body. Like I don't say like my hand is different. I say this is my body that includes my hand. Similarly, Krishna says, this is my part and parcel. Mamma wants the jiva loka. So these jivas are mama eva ansha. They are my part and parcel. So when we are attached to Krishna, then we are spiritualized. We are acting on Krishna's desire. Then there is a perfection. If we are detached from Krishna, then we become useless. So further advanced devotee who is perfected in that transcendental knowledge and he's acting in that transcendental knowledge in the akarma stage is that he who is satisfied with gain which comes from its own accord. So he's not striving, it's further like he's detached, he's a sannyasi now. He's not even working for feeding himself or his family, but he's completely depend on whatever comes by its own accord. Somebody gives, somebody offers food, then he can eat. Somebody doesn't offer, he doesn't eat. Such person is free from duality and does not envy, free from envy. He is not envying that, oh, these people have food and I don't have food, not envy. He is steady because he is not envy, he is free from duality, so he is steady in success and failure. He is never entangled in this material consciousness. And although performing his, so he's performing action for Krishna. Like Srila Prabhupada was printing books. He was traveling in flights. He was jet age Parivrajakacharya, right? He was using, he says, we are using this dictaphone. We are using the printing press. So he was using all the different means to please Krishna, to propagate Krishna consciousness, to bring this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita to the whole world. So one who is working like that is not entangled. This is something, a long paragraph. I think I'll just skip this. So verse 23, the work of a man who is unattached to the modes of material nature and who is fully situated in transcendental knowledge. So if you are in fully situated in transcendental knowledge, and you are acting in that knowledge, then you are free from the modes of material nature. That means you do not get the reaction. If your activity beyond modes, that means spiritual activities. The spiritual activities have no reaction. So that is akarma. So the work of such man who is beyond modes is merging entirely into transcendence. That means it becomes sacrifice for Krishna. So we will read this and we will see all of these symptoms in these verses. But here is the summary. In this section, we see there are 4 D's, 4 F's and 4 S's. That means the nature of somebody who is performing a karma, who is beyond the modes, who is acting only for pleasing for Krishna, is all of this is summarized here. That he is detached from sense gratification. But he is attached to Krishna. He is detached from modes. He is not acting according to the push and pull of the material modes. He is detached from the fruits. He is not hankering for, okay, what I will get out of it. But he is saying that, okay, whatever pleases Krishna, I will do it. He desires only bare necessities just to keep the body and soul together. Now then, 4 S, self-satisfaction. He's satisfied with whatever comes by providence. Like in verse 22, we saw Madhavendra Puri is sitting there and he's sannyasi and he's not even working to gain some fruits. But whatever Krishna provides, sometimes nobody gives food. Krishna personally came to give milk to that such person. So ever satisfied and independent, his self-control, steadiness in both success and failure. And now 4 F's, freedom from envy, does not envy anyone. Freedom from sense of proprietorship. He understands perfectly that Krishna is the proprietor of everything. I'm not the proprietor. Free from duality. He's not attached to the heat and cold, pain and pleasure. He's beyond that because he's beyond the modes. And he's fully situated in transcendental knowledge. So these are the symptoms, or these are the qualities of those who are acting in transcendental knowledge, and those who are acting in transcendence, they do not get any material reactions. There is no sinful reaction. So Krishna summarizes all this section by this verse. He says, Brahma arpanam brahma havir brahma agno brahmana hutam brahma eva tena gantavyam brahma karma samadhina. So brahma 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 brahma. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times Brahma, right? The Prabhupada translates this, a person who is fully absorbed in Krishna consciousness, Brahma arpanam. So what everything, Brahma, ultimately Krishna says, Brahmanohi pratishtaham, Brahma, this Brahman is depending on me, situated in me. We will learn that in chapter 14. So a person who is fully absorbed in Krishna consciousness is sure to attain the spiritual kingdom. Is sure to attain the spiritual kingdom. Because of his full contribution to spiritual activities, in which the consummation is absolute, and that which is offered is of the same spiritual nature. So if you do a fire sacrifice, in reference to the fire sacrifice, then you can see like there is a fire, there is a person who is offering. There are articles he's offering, like grains and ghee. And so the result is also Brahman. The thing which is offered is also Brahman. The fire is definitely Brahman. So because it is done as a sacrifice to Vishnu, as we learned in chapter 3, work has to be done as a sacrifice for Vishnu. But if one is doing in that consciousness of Krishna, or in a mood of pleasing Krishna, then all his activities, everything. Srila Prabhupada says, if someone is in Krishna consciousness, he is doing everything for Krishna, that he is in samadhi. Anything done in that samadhi stage is sacrifice for Krishna. And therefore, all the results are transcendental. Such person do not get any fruitive reaction, but he is only pleasing Krishna. And he is pleasing Krishna, so Krishna is pleased, and he is satisfied. Everybody is satisfied because he is watering the root, and root is Krishna. Okay. So let's see. The verses. Okay, verse 20. Tyaktva karma phalasangam nitya tripto nirashrayah karmani avipravritto api naiva kinchit karoti saha. Okay, volunteers for reading. Deepa Mataji, you are first.
Translation. Abandoning all attachment to the results of his activities, ever satisfied and independent, he performs no fruitative action, although engaged in all kinds of undertakings. Purport. The freedom from bondage of action is possible only in Krishna consciousness, when one is doing everything for Krishna. A Krishna conscious person acts out of pure love of Supreme Personality of Godhead, and therefore he has no attraction for the result of the action. He is not even attached to his personal maintenance, for everything is left to Krishna. Nor he is anxious to secure things, nor to protect things already in his possession. He does his duty to the best of his ability and leaves everything to Krishna. Such an unattached person is always free from the resultant reaction of good and bad. It is as though he were not doing anything. This is the sign of akarma, or action without putative reactions. Any other action, therefore, devoid of Krishna consciousness is binding upon the worker, and that is the real aspect of vikarma, as explained here before.
Thank you so much. So how to work in that stage is offer everything to Krishna. He's not wishing any results. Sometimes Srila Prabhupada gives example that a bank cashier, he handles millions of dollars, but he cannot take even a penny. So ideally, he should not be attached by looking at someone that, oh, he has $1 million in account. And he should not try to see how can I steal from there. So if he's not attached, so a transcendentalist is also similarly working for Krishna. And he's not attached because he is working on behalf of Krishna. Everything is left to Krishna. That person actually becomes free from anxiety. And actually, if you see the, even in material world, if you are working for your job or your school or anything that you are doing, you will become more productive, right? You're not anxious that, oh my God, I have to get this much grade. Oh, I have to, you know, get this output. I need to satisfy this customer. I have this deadline. You will be working with cool mind because you are not in anxiety. You don't depend on coffee and tea and smoking to finish your deadlines. I have seen devotees, they are very comfortable. They have their own set routine and they are much more productive than anybody who is not devotee. Because a devotee is, you know, does not have any distraction in life. He is simply working to please Krishna. So he does not bother about, you know, what will happen, this will happen, that will happen. That doesn't mean that devotees are lazy. They are working. They have a regulated lifestyle. They are working for Krishna. And if there is a certain need, they can extend themselves. Like devotees, when they do Rath Yatra, they may work overnight. Like there is a Janmashtami festival, that they are fasting the whole day and they are doing midnight arati, and so they are actually working very hard. Srila Prabhupada was interviewed one time, like, you know, so why don't you guys work? And Srila Prabhupada says, I am working more than you. I sleep only 3-4 hours. You cannot work like me. He says, like, I am always traveling. I'm always translating these books. I'm always meeting all the dignitaries. I'm always teaching my disciples. I'm replying all the letters to my students. So he was always busy. He was not wasting even a second. Because he was doing for pleasing Krishna. So he is doing a karma. So when we do everything for Krishna, then we are doing a karma. There was one term, karma, right? Karma, vikarma, akarma. So because we are not following any scripture rules and regulations, we don't properly understand what is prescribed. Even if we understand the scripture rules, we don't have the prescribed ingredients and facilities to perform karma as prescribed in Vedas. Therefore, actually, when we don't perform a karma, when we are not doing anything for Krishna, actually everything else is vikarma. We are not able to do any, even the, you know, the pious activities, even the karma kandya thing we cannot do in this age. So Srila Prabhupada, therefore, in the last sentence here is saying, if you are not doing a karma, then you are doing only vikarma. So verse 21, nirashir yad chittatma Tyakta sarva parigraha shariram kevalam karma kurvanna apnoti kilvesham. Okay, who is next? Vipin Prabhu, you are next. Are you there?
Yes.
Please read.
So, translation. Such a man of understanding acts with mind and intelligence perfectly controlled, gives up all sense of proprietorship over his possessions, and acts only for the bare necessities of life. Thus working, he is not affected by sinful reactions. Purport. A Krishna conscious person does not expect good or bad results in his activities. His mind and intelligence are fully controlled. He knows that because he is part and parcel of the Supreme, the part played by him as a part and parcel of the whole is not his own activity, but is only being done through him by the Supreme. When the hand moves, it does not move out of its own accord, but by the endeavor of the whole body. A Krishna conscious person is always dovetailed with the Supreme desire, for he has no desire for personal sense gratification. He moves the machine. As a machine part requires oiling and cleaning for maintenance, so a Krishna conscious man maintains himself by his work just to remain fit for action in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. He is therefore immune to all the reactions of his endeavors. Like an animal, he has no proprietorship even over his own body. A cruel proprietor of an animal sometimes kills the animal in his possession, yet the animal does not protest, nor does it have any real independence. A Krishna conscious person fully engaged in self-realization has very little time to falsely possess any material object. For maintaining body and soul, he does not require unfair means of accumulating money. He does not, therefore, become contaminated by such material sins. He is free from all reactions to his actions.
Thank you so much. Is there something interesting thing you learned from this reading?
You're asking me, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think this actually reminds me of another verse from the Gita. I think it is Karmanyeva Adhikaraste Mahaphaleshu Kadachana. So freedom from the fruits of the... Don't expect the fruits of your actions. Just do your job. I think this is kind of related to that. At least that's what is standing out for me.
Yeah, somewhat related.
Yes.
So this is at the higher level.
Okay.
There he was saying, like, you don't have adhikar for the fruits because you are not the owner of the work. You are not the, beneficiary. Because you are not the owner of the project, you are not the owner of the work, you are not providing the input, so you don't deserve the output. That's direct. He's telling the quality of person who is already acting in that consciousness. There he says, okay, this is what it is, theory, then here it is practical. Okay. Anybody have any problem with this? Anything shocking? Cruel proprietor of an animal sometimes kills the animal. Is there scary that we have to be like that? Srila Prabhupada is directly telling that we have to be like such, non-protesting animal of Krishna.
Like a sacrificial goat or a lamb.
Yeah. So a sacrificial goat, or you can say like you are just obedient. You are Krishna's dog. Sometimes devotees say, I'm Krishna's dog.
Yes.
So that means fully obedient. Like you don't have your own agenda, but you work on Krishna's agenda. Krishna says, wake up at 2 o'clock in the night. Yes, sir. Krishna says, okay, sleep. Then you sleep. So in other words, we become Krishna's bodily part, right? Like a machine part. So Krishna says, okay, now time to wake up, then you wake up, like that. Time to act, then you act. So that is the thing, we don't have our own independence. That doesn't mean that, we become dumb and then, because I'm not getting anything, so why should I do anything? So I become depressed. Some people get depressed from this. But actually, this is not depression. This is actually the most motivational instruction that, you know, don't protest, because all your anxiety is because of protest. So that means just submit yourself. Krishna is saying, Sarva Dharmaan Paritajya Maam Ekam Saranam Raja. So, you know, we just take Krishna's shelter, and Krishna is the best master in the world. Krishna is the richest, most famous, most beautiful, most strongest. So there is, you know, Krishna is saying, we'll learn in chapter 9, that, you know, whatever you have, I protect. Whatever you lack, I provide. So if you don't have something, then I provide you. If you have something, I preserve there. So, you know, Krishna is not cruel. Krishna is not going to kill like this, sometime like this, cruel proprietor. Krishna is taking best care of our needs. So then, you know, everything that we are doing is for Krishna, and then there is no sinful reaction. Verse 22. Yadrichaya lava santustro dvanda tito vimasarha samasiddhava suddhocha vitvapi na nivadhyate. Okay, who is next? Sablina Mataji, you are next in my screen.
Yeah, Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
He who is satisfied with gain, which comes of its own accord, which is free from duality and which does not envy, who is steady in both success and failure, is never entangled, although performing actions. A Krishna conscious person does not make much endeavor even to maintain his body. He is satisfied with gains which are obtained of their own accord. He neither begs nor borrows, but he labors honestly as far as in his power, and is satisfied with whatever is obtained by his own honest labor. He is therefore independent in his livelihood. He does not allow anyone's service to hamper his own service in Krishna consciousness. However, for the service of Lord, he can participate in any kind of action without being disturbed by the duality of the material world. The duality of the material world is felt in terms of heat and cold, or misery and happiness. A Krishna consciousness person is above duality because he does not hesitate to act in any way for satisfaction of Krishna. Therefore, he is steady both in success and in failure. These signs are visible when one is fully in transcendental knowledge.
Thank you. So when we are fully in transcendental knowledge, that means, you know, we understand we are not this body. We understand we are servant of Krishna. Some people teach you meditation, I'm not this body, I'm not my mind. But what I am, they don't know. Srila Prabhupada helps us here. Krishna tells in Bhagavad Gita, Mamma vasu jiva loka, you are my part and parcel, you are my servant, you surrender to me. So when we act in that relationship, that means we are in full transcendental knowledge. So when we are in that transcendental knowledge, then we are steady in both success and failure. Because we understand we are not this body, so anything in the material world is, you know, whether it is so-called pain or pleasure, it is within the material realm. So such person is not affected of the duality, because he is beyond the bodily concept. So therefore, he is not affected. But this is not that we can imitate. We are not yet there. But those who are fully in their stage, they are free from envy. Actually, this is the last stage. The envy is something in everyone's heart, whoever is in material world, because it is the reason for being in material world is because we become envious of God. Why only God is enjoyer? Why not we? So when we understand, we revive our consciousness, when we come in touch with pure devotees who are free from envy, then we can also learn to be free from envy. Gradually, by their association and their mercy, we can become free from envy. And only because we become free from envy, we can enter into Krishna's spiritual world back there. As long as we have envy, we cannot go back to Godhead, because there is envy is upset in the spiritual world. That's what we learn from the devotees. So verse 23, gata sangasya muktasya jnanavastita cetasah agyaya charat karma samagram pravilyate. Okay, who is next? The next one is Prachi. Can you read? You may not read, right? Okay, let's see. Aditya.
Translation. The work of a man who is unattached to the modes of material nature and who is fully situated in transcendental knowledge merges entirely into transcendence. Purport. Becoming fully Krishna conscious, one is freed from all dualities and thus is free from contaminations of the material modes. He can become liberated because he knows his constitutional position in relationship with Krishna, and thus his mind cannot be drawn from Krishna consciousness. Consequently, whatever he does for Krishna, who is the primal Vishnu. Therefore, all his works are technically sacrifices, because sacrifice aims at satisfying the Supreme Person, Vishnu Krishna. The resultant reactions to all such works certainly merge into transcendence, and one does not suffer material effects.
All work of such man is technically sacrifice. Why sacrifice? Because he is doing everything as sacrifice to Krishna. He is offering everything to Krishna. So one has to work in that Krishna consciousness. And then how to develop that Krishna consciousness? Srila Prabhupada gives us a very easy method, chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Because he says, Kali Kale Nama Rupa Krishna Avatar. Krishna is present in his name in this Kali Yuga. So that's as is. Whenever we are chanting, we are with Krishna. Whenever we are with Krishna, we are in Samadhi. And we are in Samadhi, that means we are sacrificing for Krishna, right? So that means there is no material reaction. And we are preparing ourselves to go back to Godhead in that liberated stage. Now, concluding verse for today, 24. Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmagno Brahmana Hutam Brahmevatena Gantavyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. Okay, Anil Prabhu, you are also there. Are you able to read today?
Yes, Prabhu.
Great. Please do.
Translation. A person who is fully absorbed in Krishna consciousness is sure to attain the spiritual kingdom because of his full contribution to spiritual activities, in which the consummation is absolute and that which is offered is of the spiritual nature. How activities in Krishna consciousness can lead one ultimately to the spiritual goal is described here. There are various activities in Krishna consciousness, and all of them will be described in the following verses. But for the present, just the principle of Krishna consciousness is described. A conditioned soul entangled in material contamination is sure to act in the material atmosphere, and yet he has to get out of such an environment. The process by which the conditioned soul can get out of the material atmosphere is Krishna consciousness. For example, a patient who is suffering from a disorder of the bowels due to overindulgence in milk products is cured by another milk product, namely curds. The materially absorbed conditioned soul can be cured by Krishna consciousness as set forth here in the Gita. The process is generally known as yajna, or activities simply meant for the satisfaction of Vishnu or Krishna. The more the activities of the material world are performed in Krishna consciousness, not for Vishnu only, the more the atmosphere becomes spiritualized by complete absorption. The word Brahma means spiritual. The Lord is spiritual, and the rays of his transcendental body are called Brahma Jyotir, his spiritual effulgence. Everything that exists is situated in the Brahma Jyotir, but when the Jyotir is covered by illusion or Sanskritification, it is called material. There is material wheel can be removed at once by Krishna consciousness just by offering the sale of just the offering for the sake of Krishna consciousness. The consuming agent of such an offering or contribution, the process of consumption, the contributor and the result are all combined together. Brahman or the absolute truth. The absolute truth covered by Maya is called matter. Matter dovetailed for the cause of the absolute truth regains its spiritual quality. Krishna consciousness is the process of converting the illusory consciousness into Brahman or the supreme. When the mind is fully absorbed in Krishna consciousness, it is said to be in samadhi or trance. Anything done in such transcendental consciousness is called yajna or sacrifice for the absolute. In that condition of spiritual consciousness, the contributor, the contribution, consumption, the performer, or the reader of the performance and result or ultimate gain, everything becomes one in the absolute, the supreme Brahman. This is the method of Krishna consciousness.
Thank you so much. So Srila Prabhupada is helping us that Krishna consciousness is the process of converting the illusory consciousness into Brahma or the supreme. In Krishna consciousness, we are using everything in Krishna's service. So anything that is used in Krishna's service, that gets spiritualized. So the difference between matter and spirit is that something which is not used in Krishna's service is matter. Actually, Srila Prabhupada is explaining that everything is situated in Brahma Jyoti. Everything. This material world is a very insignificant lump of matter floating in Brahma Jyoti. This whole creation, which has billions and billions of universes, and each universe have trillions and trillions of planets, and each planet has so many living entities and all these resources. All of this is very insignificant part in the Brahma Jyoti. So everything is actually within Brahma Jyoti, but there is a material coating. So we are using the things for our own sense gratification, for our own consumption, without recognizing Krishna's presence, without recognizing the ownership of Krishna, then that is in illusion, that is covered by illusion. Then it is material. Otherwise, anything that you use it for Krishna's service, that thing becomes spiritualized. So like you are using the computer, or you are using a car to go to temple, you are using your money to donate the temple. Anything that you are using it in Krishna's service, that means that gets spiritualized. So when we are serving to Krishna in that way, with different articles, the things, all of those things spiritualized. When we are using our mind and intelligence in Krishna's service, our mind and intelligence also become spiritualized. And we are constantly, when we are engaging our mind and intelligence in Krishna's service, that means we become fully spiritualized, and that is the state of samadhi or liberation. And anything done in that samadhi stage is yajna. And whatever you offer, whatever things you contribute in the yajna, then everything becomes spiritualized. So Krishna consciousness it includes everything. It is not just that you go to the temple and then just ring the bell. You can spiritualize your job, like you are working for Krishna. you can become a student for Krishna. Why the example of curd and milk is given here? Can someone tell what is the significance of this example, milk and curd? Why Prabhupada talks about milk and curd? Let's see. Aditya, you are a dairy technologist. Milk and curd, your department. So how you can relate to this example?
Well, sir, like some people, they have lactose intolerance. So they if they consume milk, they face like the problem of the gut and all that. But in curd, like lactose is hydrolyzed to lactic acid. So there is less concentration of lactose. But the overall main aim of the thing is that both are from the same family, that milk and its products, and they both have their cons and pros. So now we can relate that.
So one is causing disorder, and another one is curing the disorder.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So why Prabhupada quoting this example here in this verse?
Well, we can see that, sir, like humans, we can say that humans, there are two types. One is causing disorder and others are Krishna devotees. They are trying to help them. Maybe like that. I don't know, sir.
Okay.
I can tell, Prabhu.
Yes.
So some people like, we are trying to live in the material world. Like, even like when we look at our elders and everything, like what we do is like, we live a mechanical life, like going to work and coming back to work. Going to work and coming back from work to home. We will only concentrate on these two activities regularly, and rest of the time we spend our time for buying groceries and those things. I mean, I'm just giving some examples, but we don't do anything to please Krishna. So whenever we are doing work, if you think that we are working for the sake of Krishna, then our life will not be considered as material, but it will be considered as spiritualized.
Yes. So work is same. The milk is the source of these two products, milk and curd or yogurt, is same, right? So like the work is also same, right? But one work is for self-consumption, which is like milk, which will cause disorder, sinful reaction. And then the other work, one man is, you know, working for Krishna is like a, you know, curing. If you're doing the same work, going to office and coming home and shopping, but this is all for Krishna's service. Like if you are, you know, surrender to Krishna. So you get instruction from a spiritual master. That's why it's very essential to have a spiritual master and get instruction from the spiritual master to understand what is my duty. It is not that simply I can assume that, oh, my duty is this, so, you know, I am offering. So how to offer one's work is to get the instruction from Krishna. How to get instruction from Krishna? By instruction of a spiritual master. So we have to accept Krishna through spiritual master, and spiritual master advises, okay, this is the way you work and this is the way you don't work. So once we work like that, we may be going to the same office. Spiritual master may say, okay, you just be in the same job. So when we are still in the same job, but now we are doing it on the order of a spiritual master and we are following direction of a spiritual master, that means following direction of Krishna. So we are offering the results to Krishna. Actually, we offer everything to Krishna. Like, you know, I mean, we may use our resources in the job, like we can tell others about, you know, surrender to Krishna, or we may not directly say, but we may tell them about importance of my life, like, you know, why I'm satisfied, why I'm not greedy, why I do the things in regulated time, why I'm not stressed up for deadlines. So people see our quality, and then, you know, when we act in that Krishna consciousness, when we develop that qualities, then people get inspired. So that is a way that we can inspire others. It's all in Krishna's service. Our whole lifestyle can become you know, service to Krishna. So the same job, but it is done in the mood of pleasing to Krishna. That means it becomes yoga. Is that clear now, Aditya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, yeah. So that's how it is. Like, work is work, but one is done for sense gratification, for selfishness, and another one is done for service of Krishna. So that's how it cures. Service of Krishna will cure our material conditioning. It will bring us away from these material modes. And once we are away from the material mode, then there is no reaction. The material reaction, the sinful reaction happens only when we are acting within the modes. Anybody else have something to add or clarify something? Anything that they learned something new today, they want to add? Okay. So this was the section C, a karma topic, how to act with transcendental knowledge as a service to Krishna and become free from all sinful reactions. And individually, like in 24, Srila Prabhupada says this verse is like a principle of Krishna consciousness, but the details will be described in the following section. So the details, like what kind of yajna one can perform, what kind of activity and sacrifice one can perform, Krishna will tell at different stage of one's life. We can learn those things, more details, in next section. Any last point or comment, anything else? Okay. If not, thank you so much. Everybody can chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
See you next week.
Thank you.
See you next week. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, see you next week. Hare Bhav. Hare Krishna. Somebody is there.
Yes, sir. I'm trying to log out.
Oh, okay. How are you?
I'm good, sir.
Good. Nice.